Okay, so I just uploaded the other part, I mean the hero showcase, more or less. And yeah, so now let's look at the real gameplay updates. Okay, so first, there was a courier update. So, now every player has his own courier automatically. I would say that means that you don't have to buy couriers anymore. And the couriers all have levels. And depending on the level, they gain movement speed, health, and gold per minute. So you now get gold per minute for your courier, if they are alive. And so now you get 85 on level 1 instead of the 91. And that increases by 60 GPM if you are level 30. So you can get up to 145 GPM per minute. And the courier has flying movement speed, flying movement at level 5. And yeah, then he gets an ability at level 10, the speed burst for 6 seconds, 50% more movement speed. Level 15, he is able to place down observer wards and sentry wards. That's actually quite nice for a supporter. So now you can stay on lane and simply use the courier to place down some wards. Level 20, you get the shield, so the invulnerability for the courier. And at level 25, so everything is at your own level, because the courier shares your level. At level 25, he can use his item, can use items. So in theory, you can have a Dagon on your own hero, a E-Blade on your hero, and then Dagon, Dagon with the courier together as the second Dagon. And yeah, he simply also has a shorter Western range, the courier, and the team bounty is, I would say, is a bit higher, I think, because now it's depending on the level of the courier. And the respawn timer is also changed from 120 and 180 to 50 plus 7 seconds for every level. Okay, so now to the economy. Observer boss. What no longer cost gold, and you now start with 3 town portal scrolls. And the gold earned from killing observer boss always goes to the player who bought the true sight. Here. And now, also, if you have a debuff or dealt any damage to an enemy hero that dies in the you also get the assist. I mean the assist gold. Even if you are no longer alive or within the area. Means if you have, I think, it's like if you are Doom and you have Scorched Earth active and TP out, you still get the assist gold for the kill. Okay, the map layout has is redesigned so that both ancient, ancient camps are on one side of on the further in the jungle, further away from Roshan. And heroes can now get up to level 30, and with level 30 you get all the entire talent tree. So more or less, talents choosing the right talent only matters for the early game. And respawn time doesn't increase past level 25. And also the XP bounty for the enemies isn't increasing past level 25. And you need 3.5k, 4.5, 5.5, 6.5 and 7.5k XP per level up after level 25. And spell immunity now doesn't make it so that you don't take damage if the beforehand. Piercing spells could stun you, I think it was, and now they also deal the damage if you if they are piercing. And the sideshot got removed and replaced by a Okay, I don't find it right now. Okay, the secret drops got replaced by a building, that you can capture with for your team, and when you have captured it, you get 25 XP. You get a little bit of XP every 5 minutes. And right now there's also a bug where you can use the Snapfire.
Perfect.
To
I got bacon to do.
To let the
I am the void and the
to
spirit.
Let the building jump out of the map. Maybe now it's also already got fixed because I got the message that my game isn't up to date anymore. Okay, so let's tier 2 towers. HP has increased by 100. The armor has increased by 1 and the damage by 23. The vision range has increased by 300 and the multi-shot from the glyph activation is now from 2 to 4, so you can attack 4 targets more. And the glyph duration increased by 1 second. And the Night Towers also now give both teams half of the bounty instead of 0 gold for both teams, and siege damage, so the catapult damage against heroes is now from 85 to 100, so you catapult still 15% more damage against yourself. The fountain got a small damage buff and has now 20% accuracy, so piercing evasion. Okay, then a few equips had a few changes, but yeah, just the cloak aura does no longer stack. Poison from the rule assassin, the poison debuff applies a 35% region reduction, so nothing that big, I would say. Okay, most cooldowns have reduced, but yeah. So, oh yeah, and the new building that's replaced the Cytrops is the outpost. And you can also TP to it, like from a tier 1, so it's a 6 second TP delay, and you get 25 XP per minute. I mean, the bonus XP is 25 per minute that the game lasts. So the first time they activate is after 10 minutes, so the first time they give you 250 XP. And they also give you true sight around them. So they're quite useful against the wiki, I would say. Because you only always have a small area of true sight. And also, neutral creeps now drop items. And 62 items, and also... Okay, here the chances. That's based on the minutes the game has lasts, and 5 to 15, so the first 5 minutes there's no drop. Then 5 to 15 minutes you have a 10% chance of a tier 1 item drop. And yeah, I don't think that it's necessary to wait. It's always 10% for the tier, and always for a 10 minute period. But, and also, there are way too many items, but we're gonna go over through. So, keen optics, cast range, and mana. Pretty useful for support hero, I would say. I mean, 1.5 mana region, if you're lucky, you can get it at minutes 5. And yeah, Royal Jelly is a permanent buff. You can consume it, and you get 2.5 HP and 1.25 mana region. It has two charges, and you can use it on yourself, and you have to use the second time on one of your teammates because it isn't stacking on the same unit. Then the Pullman Shield got reintroduced. Now it drops, and also the Iron Talon, and you can place down a mango tree that will drop a mango every 60 seconds, and also provide a 800 vision around it. Then you have more or less small arcane boots, because they restore 75 mana to all allies in a range of 1200 on a 40 second cooldown. The broom handle gives melee units attack range and a little bit of damage and armor. And you can now also place down a special tree, Ironwood tree. And yeah. And a shovel gives a 1 second channel, and you can found a bounty rune, a flask, two charges of a TP scroll, so two TP scrolls, or a kobold, so a small creep. Then the tier 2 items are you can get vampire fangs with lifesteal and spell lifesteal, both 10%, and plus 450 night vision. So if you're playing against a night stalker, you should try to get it. Then also the Ring of Aquila is now droppable by creeps, so you get armor and mana region. Repair kit, so you can repair towers, I would guess. And they also get the plus 4 multi-shot, like cliff, in the 30 seconds that this item is active, and it restores 40% of their health. Then Pupil's Gift, plus 14 attribute in both of your secondary attributes. So if you're a strength carry, you get plus 14 agility and int. Then is there something else? Oh, Philosopher's Stone, plus 75 GPM. That is more or less doubling your starting GPM. But you lose 35 attack damage. So more or less for supporters, I guess. Because it's only physical damage and not spell damage. So if you're Crystal Maiden or so, you the Philosopher's Stone is useful. And by the way, all dropped items are shareable among your team. So a carry can give it to a support. Dragon Scale is interesting. Plus 5 armor and 5 HP, and you have 12 seconds, 12 damage per second for 3 seconds, even on buildings. So you have a burn damage. And Tome of Agnim, you get a scepter buff for 3 minutes. So it's you get a small Agnim scepter for 3 minutes. That's nice. Then Quaggy code 13 ammo, but you lose attack speed. A greater fairy fire. Base is you get 30 damage, but you can heal 500 health with it. Yeah. Mindbreaker, you get mana break. That's level tier 3, so after minute 35. And wait, you get the mana that you burn from the enemy. So it's not like Diffusal Blade where you simply destroy the mana. You get it. It's more like a mana drain for yourself. Then the third eye, it's more or less a gem that you can drop, and after you died 3 times, you lose it. Then you have spider legs. I think it's even higher than the movement speed is higher than boot movement speed with 24%. And you also get a turn rate increase, so you turn faster. Clumsy Net, also a support buff item, because you can wood the enemy, I mean ensnare the enemy, and but you also ensnare yourself, so it's useful if you're support and the enemy is running away from a carry, I would say. The Paladin's Sword, a little bit of damage, 17% lifesteal, and region and lifesteal amplifier, so 17% more region and lifesteal. Orb of Destruction is more or less like a Desolator, weak one with 6 armor reduction, and also a slow of 30 for melee and 50 for ranged heroes. Titan Sliver. This could be really strong, because you get additional 22% base damage, and also 22% status resistance and magic resistance. Okay, the tier 4 items. You can swap you can get more max HP, but you lose your mana. And can increase your attack projectile speed. And also your next attack hexes the enemy for 1.5 seconds on a 12 seconds cooldown with the princess knife. And yeah, telescope. So you can use your scanning ability, that's the team based team ability, right next to the map. The cooldown is decreased by 50%. And yeah. Illusion escape. That would be OP on a Phantom Lancer because the illusions deal 10% more damage. Havoc Hammer increases your basic attack time by 0.3 and can be used to knock enemies and slow the movement speed for a short period of time. And the magic lamp, hard dispel, so you get out of stuns. It's more like, more or less like Tidehunter Kraken's passive. And also you get a 15% heal if you fall below 300 HP on a 75 second cooldown. Then I think the level also has the cleave for ranged units because there is 400 and 250 area. I think the 250 is the ranged unit area. And Minotaur Horn is, I would even say, a stronger BKB. You have 20 strength and you get a magic immunity for 1.75 seconds on the 40 second cooldown. And the tier 5 items, oh, means only 70 minutes plus. I think they are, I hope they are getting wait, Mirror Shield, 75% chance to block and reflect targeted spells. If you're a Spectre, you have to get it, I would say. Then you also can combine a Blink Dagger and Meteor Hammer to an item that grants you 20 strength, 20 int, 15 HP and 10 mana region. And then you turn into a Meteor. Applying the Meteor Hammer stun and damage. 15 seconds cooldown and does not get disabled by incoming damage. So more or less you blink in and you will instantly become a Meteor and have a small blink stun, more or less. Then you also can fusion rune. Three charges and you simply get all the buffs of all the runes. So double damage, reach, and arcane rune buffs and illusion buff. So yeah, Apex plus 80% of your primary attribute. So if you only buy, this means you have 100 agility, you get 80 plus agility. Or the ballista plus 400 attack range. So you basic, if you're any kind of range units, you more or less get the passive of sniper. But don't forget this only after 70 minutes. Woodland Striders. No max movement speed limit. And you get 50% more movement speed and 50 HP region. And you can run through the trees. Wow, that's strong. Then the Trident, that's a combination of Sand, Yasha and Kaya. I mean, a recipe for the combination, and you get 33 in all stats, 33 movement speed. You get more or less 33 in everything. Then Book of the Dead, it's three necrobooks at once. You summon the 6 level 3 Necronomicon units for 90 seconds. On a 75 second cooldown, so you can permanently have three melee and 3 ranged necro units. Then Ex Machina is better refresher orb because only 30 seconds cooldown. And Desolator 2, 100 attack damage and 12 minus armor on attack. And the Phoenix Ash, 30 into all stats, and lethal damage is prevented and it heals you to full HP. But it only has one charge, so it's more or less like a Aegis. Then the items. Stout Shield now got removed, and probably because you can now get the. What's it called again? The Puman Shield from Creeps. Then mostly costs. Vanguard now needs a recipe. Quelling Blade is cheaper, but also gives you less damage. Most items simply cost more. Fairy Fire costs more. Enchanted Mango can now be stacked up to 3 times, so more or less like tangos. Four stuff recipe now 50 gold more, so ring same. Buckler now needs a ring of protection, one iron branch and a recipe, but no longer has an active ability. Ring of Basilium now requires Sage Mask, iron branch and a recipe. Okay, and Flats got is now a ring of Basilium, Morbid Mask, Buckler, recipe. Total two is a bit more expensive. Because of you also need a buckler. And it provides 6 all stats and 25% lifesteal aura instead of the 15 or 10% lifesteal for ranged. Helm of the Dominator now gives you 5 more stats and a 20% plus on your base damage as a AoE. But the HP region got reduced. Drums now give you attack speed as an AoE. And Mechanism now uses a chainmail instead of a buckler. But I don't think that we have to go over every single item. Except those with the reworked. Bloodstone now gets built from a Kaya and a Soul Booster. And gives you the bonus of both items plus the 200% mana region. And each charge gives you 0.2 mana region and 0.35 spell amp instead of the HP and mana region. Sage now also gives you a HP region buff. I mean amplification. And yeah. The Holy Locket no longer gives you heals. Healing amplification, regeneration amplification and heal amplification increased from 25 to 35, and health got increased by 50. But you need a magic wand instead of a cloak. And you also can use it like a magic wand now. Hand of Mice got more expensive. The Way of Discord now needs a Helm of Iron Will instead of the Ring of Basilium. The Heart gives you now plus 10 health region. Dust now only comes in a single charge, but for 90 gold instead. So it's more or less cost the same, but you can buy it with more easily. Sentry Wards now last 2 minutes longer, and the replenishing in the shop is needs 10 seconds more, and the initial stack got reduced from 4 to 3. Smoke now takes only 7 minutes to replenish. Yeah. And the Monkey King now pierces spell immunity, so the passive of the Monkey King bar now also is against BKB, useful. Divine Rapier now has 2 strike. That's a nice update actually for the Divine Rapier. Link's Spear now has only 12 seconds cooldown, and you get more 1+ in all stats. But yeah, this is all the items. And for the next video, we're gonna make the hero changes. So I hope you see you next time. So, and bye.